Autoencoders learn how to represent the data in a more compact form, in so-called latent space. It's just a bunch of numbers storing information about the input. Compacted representation can be later used to decode the original sample. They can also be used for other tasks like segmentation or improving image quality. The encoder's job is to represent the data. Let's see how it could look like for a few images. Every point represents a single image in the latent space. Now, what would happen if we tried to decode some random point from that space? In high-dimensional space, samples are very far from each other. If we randomly selected point at that space, most probably it would be spot completely unconed to the model. This is where variational autoencoders come in. Instead of producing a single latent vector, the encoder outputs two vectors, one for means and one for standard deviations of the latent features. Now, every image is represented by distribution of its features. But aren't those distributions still scattered over the latent space? During the training, we used two components: the reconstruction loss, that guides the model to be good at recreating the input data, and the divergence loss that guides the model to produce distributions close to the prior one. After training, we can sample a vector from the prior distribution, and there's a good chance it will lie in a region the model has learned. The decoder can then generate a meaningful new data sample. There's also an important detail called reparameterization trick. We could sample a vector based on encoder's outputs and feed it to the decoder, but it would make it impossible for the model to train. Instead, we generate a random vector E and use it to randomly shift the distribution outputted by the encoder. This way, the model can calculate loss with respect to the means and standard deviations, allowing it to learn.